Hi, I'm Chelsea.
And I'm Tony Northrup.
And you're watching Tony and Chelsea Live. And today is a portfolio review. And this episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform for creating a fast and easy professional website or portfolio. And if you want to try it out, you can do it for 14 days for free. You don't have to put in your credit card or anything. And if you decide that you like it, and I think you will, you can use the coupon code
Portfolio
for 10% off.
Yeah, thanks Squarespace for making all this possible. We love your site. Definitely the best way to set up a portfolio or just about any other type of website.
Yeah.
Chelsea's going to be doing most of the talking today because if you've been keeping track, we've had this is our third live broadcast in 2 days. And I've done the majority of the talking and my throat is just blown out.
It really does do a jab on your throat. So you'll be submitting your photos with leading lines today. So if there are no leading lines, we're not going to choose your photo. We have a category today because we've been getting so many pictures submitted. And you can submit your individual photos at sdp.io/submit. And you should start that now because we don't review pictures that were submitted before the show starts.
Yeah, and if you're not watching live, don't bother.
Yeah.
Just for those of you watching live, Thursday is at 5. Before we move on to that, that's right. Go for it. This is our portfolio review. That's the main focus. We're going to be looking at lots of portfolios
today. So we're going to be looking at your portfolios too, and we're going to be picking a favorite portfolio today, and we'll be awarding that person a copy of our new Lightroom book. It's still on pre-order. So if you live out of the country, you'll get a free ebook. If you live in the U.S., we'll send you a paperback and an ebook when it's available. So submit your portfolio to sdp.io/link, and once again, you have to submit it while the live show is on. So if you're watching this in the future, it's already too late.
Tune in Thursdays at 5 Eastern time.
Tony, this is your story.
Yeah, this is a kind of a cool camera from Pentax, which takes 360-degree pictures. So it has basically two fisheye lenses, 280-degree lenses on the front and the back. So you can hold it up and with a snap of your finger, take a panorama of your entire surroundings.
You know how many selfies I could take with that?
Yeah, it does make a cool selfie because you can hold it out there. They've had this before, but this one records video, kind of. It only does it at 15 frames a second.
Okay.
Which would be jerky and nobody would ever want to watch 15 frames a second video. So anyway, I just thought it was cool enough to mention, but I'll probably hold off until...
What would you use it for?
I think as a videographer, it'd be really cool to be able to capture an entire 360 scene. You could then pan around if you wanted to, or you could make those cool, like, small planet things.
What's the image quality video. Like?
It's not great. It's okay.
Okay.
It's what you'd expect. It's GoPro-ish, but only 1080, so not really GoPro-ish.
Oh, 1080 is pretty
old
good.
Old GoPro-ish.
This would be good for realtors.
Yeah, maybe it would be.
So.
Wow.
You're probably thinking, why are all these naked ladies on the screen? This is a story I found really interesting. American Eagle is now not photoshopping any of their underwear or bra pictures because Victoria's Secret was getting such a big backlash for over photoshopping. So if you look at these pictures closely, you can see birthmarks and some scars and just
she has like a tattoo.
Yeah, a tattoo peeking out. And the reason why I think this is significant is because I think people are getting really tired of overprocessed pictures. Like the magic is gone. We all know how Photoshop works. It's really accessible. Yeah. Everyone's using it. And sometimes there's a time and a place for it. And sometimes you just want to see human skin again. So I think this is interesting. Their sales went up like 10% when they stopped photoshopping their pictures because they just had such a positive feedback from their customers, and I think we'll see more of this.
And I also think it's an interesting time to kind of explore Photoshop's role in taking pictures overall, especially commercial and portrait type photos, because as you and I both know, they often make this big deal like we're not using Photoshop now, but it's not like they're taking a picture of the model when they're getting out of bed.
Right.
No, now they rely on makeup and lighting and posing.
Right.
And there's so much you can do
and
with those techniques.
People that are prettier than 99.999% of the rest of the population.
Well, there's that, but that's also still just a starting point. So you can do things like the way she has her body kind of shifted to the side here a little bit helps to accentuate her waist.
It gives her a waist.
I'll say the fact that her arm is pressed up against her body doesn't do anything to flatter her form.
Yeah. But I think that it's, I don't know. I think we'll see more of this. I think people are going to back off of the editing
Yeah, it would be nice, and if nothing else, it saves you time, right?
Yeah. So we were also sent this Steadicam Curve for our GoPro. We just got it in the mail not even an hour ago, so we haven't had a chance to use it, but I just wanted to show you guys that we have it and we will be reviewing it. Justin, you'll be using it.
Yeah.
We're going to get a Justin review.
Yeah, if you're not familiar, a Steadicam kind of gives you those flying video shots where everything is nice and smooth, and you see them in movies pretty constantly.
Yeah.
Anytime something's tracking and is not bouncing all around, there's a Steadicam in use. And Steadicams tend to be very expensive.
This is $100 for this mini one.
Yes. For a real Steadicam, it's easy to spend over $1,000. They're also extremely hard to use. So we have to warn you, don't go buy this and think you're going
to
get like some smooth flying shot.
Yeah, you have
buy to buy it and spend like weeks and weeks using it and maybe you can work it out. But Steadicam operator is a job that you will see in the credits of a movie. Because it's not a regular cameraman. Like, it's a physical job.
Well, when we first started doing video, it was just Tony and I. And yeah. I was operating the camera, and he got me a Steadicam because, like, if you know me, I have zero attention span and no patience. So I was like, and you thought I could use it. And it's just, it takes so much practice. It was kind of frustrating.
Yeah, it'd be like a beginning photographer who went right out and bought a 600 millimeter f4. Like, there's a learning curve to it, and that I did not understand. So I thought we could just get those cool Steadicam shots. But I never got good at the Steadicam. I couldn't master it.
Well, this seems
it is a job.
This seems more manageable because it's light.
Yeah.
And when we were looking through the manual, it seems like it's a little easier to adjust. So we'll see.
Yeah, stay tuned and we'll give you a more thorough review. Another bit of new gear that we have.
What?
7D Mark II. Maybe you heard of it.
Oh, I've heard so much about it. I wish I could escape it. It's all that's been in the Northrop household the past few days.
Yeah,
so.
It's taken over our lives for a little bit.
Yeah.
But what do you think of it?
I really love it. Yeah. I like
it. At least
so far.
For wildlife, which is maybe our favorite type of photography. It's remarkable. It's just the best wildlife camera I've ever used.
Yeah, we like it so far. But we want to spend more time with it to see.
Yeah, it's one of those things where wildlife takes like months to get a good picture. It's not like you go out and do it. You have to live with it. So we did a short-term review that you might have seen, and then I updated it today with another live broadcast. But we'll have another longer review coming soon.
Yeah.
Speaking of that,
what?
We are kind of clearing out our closets a little bit because we're always, a lot of times we have to buy gear in order to review it. So we end up with a stockpile of a ridiculous number of cameras, far more than we could ever use. So we're unloading some of them, and it's a good opportunity to buy them directly from us. We're selling them all for fair prices.
We should include something like a DVD with them.
We include everything with them. Thank you for bringing that up.
Oh.
Our DVD set
that's
or Blu-ray.
That's too generous.
All three of our books. And we're still selling it for a fair used price. So right now we have a D3300, entry-level Nikon DSLR. We have Olympus EM10, which is our favorite travel camera.
Yeah.
The Fujifilm X-T1, which is an amazing camera for those of you
loving.
Oh, I
really like that. We're selling that.
We just have so many cameras.
I know.
you can get them all at sdp.io/used. And you'll also see a camera that's not used on there, the Samsung NX1, which everybody is asking us about.
Yeah, so we're going to try something new to see if we can review more gear. We're going to put it up for sale, buy it, review it, and then we'll give it to you. So if you want that camera, you can buy it through us, and we'll include everything. We have three books, a DVD series or a Blu-ray, and you'll get access to our groups and hours of video and things. So if that's something you'd be interested in doing and you've been looking at that camera, good opportunity.
Yeah, so go here and fund our NX1 review. All those people who are interested in it, just take a leap of faith and loan us your NX1 for a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Get some free stuff out of it and our thanks.
It's a good way for us to like fund these reviews without being biased, because a lot of people get sponsored by someone or something and then you have these biased reviews. But wouldn't it stink if someone bought it and we reviewed it and we're like, hate it.
Awful.
Here you go.
Yeah, well, we're kind of handing that risk off to them. But a lot of people are going to be ordering it anyway, and they won't be waiting for reviews. Chit-chat.
Chit and chat.
We respond to your comments and questions.
Giuseppe. Hi, Tony. First of all, congratulations for your very detailed reviews. Just a question. Will you test also the Samsung NX? It seems to be an interesting competitor, and I would like to have your impression on it. Bye.
Yeah, I totally stepped on that question.
Yeah, you did. You just...
Yes. Well, if you feel like buying the NX1, buy it from us.
Remember that.
We'll ship it to you in a couple of weeks. sdp.io/used.
David Greenwell, wouldn't it be easier just to have a bar fridge in your studio?
We have discussed this.
This is a good
idea. The fridges make a humming noise that would be picked up in the studio. So for the time being,
that's right.
We're just going to have to carry our beer downstairs. It's hard times.
I just feel like that's so sad. Everyone must feel so sorry for us.
I know. Maybe we could set up some sort of donation thing.
Yeah.
Maybe they could invent a silent refrigerator. Oh, one tier.
Guardian Observer says, it seems that there is a war on YouTube between camera and lens manufacturers. I know. And we're in the middle of it, and it's so stressful because, like, we were so excited about this 7D Mark II, and then DxO Mark put out the reviews, and there's just a shit storm. People freaked out. I can't believe it's like when you see an article and it's really biased, but then everyone just believes it because they're like, guys, I read stuff. It must be true. Like, people just get crazy over any little review. I just think a healthy dose of skepticism would be good, or like analyzing the data yourself. You did it.
Yeah, people have a very emotional connection. Some people have an emotional connection with the things that they buy. It's a major purchase, and they, I don't know, it's like cognitive dissonance. Like, they feel, I'm a smart person, therefore whatever I buy must have been the best.
I get it. It's almost like sour grapes. It's like you ask someone out and they say no, and you're like, well, you're kind of short for me anyway. You know, it's like almost the opposite of that. Like, you committed to spending thousands of dollars on a system. So you're like, no, the other one must stink because I'm heavily invested in this.
Yeah, you can't reconcile, subconsciously, you can't reconcile that you might have not made the right choice. So you have to then change reality, and your emotions become, the technical aspects become bound to your self-esteem and thus your emotions.
And if that weren't true, we wouldn't have so many people just swearing at each other in comment sections.
Yeah, they would just...
I don't even go on DP Review anymore because they get personal. Like, they talk about like our features and our relationship because they're mad we don't like the gear that they use.
I know.
It's so silly. Like,
whenever you see emotions like that, you can tell somebody's behaving irrationally without logic. Yeah. We're totally open to people who say, hey, this might be a mistake. And in fact, part of the video that I did today was retracting some of the statements before. I was like, oh, this is worth reconsidering. So I just put up a couple of corrections along with a bunch of new information.
We can be wrong. We're not ashamed of that.
Yeah, I don't have any feelings about that. I'm just like, there's new information. Let's process it, publish whatever the results
are. This is when we reveal that we're actually robots.
Yeah.
We don't have feelings about anything.
I would never have lived to be over 350 years if I weren't mostly Android.
How do you think I look this good at 47?
Clearly.
Robot. I'm not 47.
Justin is treating us to burgers, yeah. I don't...
I said Justin is treating us to burgers on Twitter, and someone asked if he lived with us in a little nest in the basement made of packing peanuts. And that's uncanny because he does. No, he doesn't. Come on. He doesn't live in our basement.
Not with packing peanuts, anyway.
But he does work from our house like a few times a week. And today he brought us Omaha steak burgers. And they were
Justin
so
is the man.
Good. And then he even gave me his Gouda cheese to put on mine. And it was like smoked. It was crazy.
I have a new favorite cheese. I don't know. I guess I didn't have previous experience with Gouda. But I was eating that stuff straight.
Oh my
hardcore,
gosh.
Raw.
That was
right
crazy good, Justin. We need to get more of that.
Yeah, I need more burgers and more Gouda.
Wow.
Maybe we should take a minute and look at some portfolios. That's what we're doing here today.
Let's just talk about cheese. Let's do cheese reviews.
This portfolio is hosted on Squarespace, our favorite hosting provider and the sponsor of the show. You can go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio if you want to sign up.
That was really good. That was really good, Tony.
Pet photography. So this is interesting. They have a real specialty here. And it is becoming a more and more popular specialty as, like, people start taking more of their own pictures.
Yeah, yeah. I love that one. Go back. He looks like a big, scary bunny.
Yeah, these are really thoughtful portraits. I like the low-key background there.
Yeah. So because we're going to have a winner today, we should talk about things that we like and don't like, just so that we can kind of, like, casually make a quick decision about this thing.
Yeah, we'll have to be keeping track of a score. I love the water here. I might even lead with this picture. This is the one that
I like
caught
that,
my eye.
I like environmental shots for animals better than studio.
Good studio shots can be great. Who's the photographer with the, read my mind here, Weinerhammers?
Oh, William Wegman?
William Wegman, is that right?
I think so.
Anyway, he does pose studio shots and they can just be amazing. We've tried pet photography, like more formal pet photography with our animals.
Dogs are just
and
dumb.
Sandy's a monster who loses her mind. She can't do anything.
You and offer a treat and she just goes crazy.
Yeah, it's like kid photography, but even more extreme. Oh. Like you can pretty much get any kid to behave with the right amount of candy and discipline. But dogs, man, and cats, you're
kids,
not never
going
to pose a cat.
You just give them a bottle of Dramamine and tape their eyes open. That's so dark.
That's not good advice.
That's really
the
dark.
The balance here is a little
the
off.
The more I thought it through, the more I was like, that's abusive. I'm okay. Like,
that's a really cute picture, actually. That's I was going to say crop that down, but it is pretty cute.
Oh, you were? So unlike you. So he didn't have too many photos. I like the layout of the site. I like his little logo with just the little dog, so you know what his photography's about.
Yeah.
And he actually sticks to it. Like, it's not like he says that he's a pet photographer and then there's all landscapes or something. Like, it makes sense so far.
Yeah, that's a beautiful picture of the swan. I love the blue in the background and all the detail. That's really nice. Yeah, I love these tight compositions.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, who's
that's
that?
Handsome.
Spooky.
Okay, let's check out. Let's see if we can figure out who Radpet is. Okay.
Aww.
He's got a gentle leader. We have these for our dogs, and they're fantastic if you walk your dogs. They turned my dog Sandy from the worst walker dragging you down the street to just a polite young lady. All it took was sticking this thing in her mouth. But people think it's like a muzzle or something. It just stops them from like pulling, and it doesn't hurt them. They're totally happy with it. She's way happier than when she was like choking herself.
Maybe they'll send us one. Maybe they'll send us one. We can talk about it.
Yeah, yeah.
Enthusiastic.
Okay. Oh, his name is Radom. I just thought his photography was radical.
Oh yeah, like rad, like cool.
Yeah, like 80s lingo.
80?
His session started at 59E. I don't know if that's Euro or if that's some weird currency that I've never heard of. I guess that's a good price.
Yeah, I would pay. I would do that.
Yeah, it actually would be nice to get some good pictures of our dogs. Okay, you know, I suggested a couple of compositional things with his pictures, maybe cropping it down a little bit, but there weren't too many pictures. I love the layout of your site. You have pricing, about, you've met pretty much everything on our checklist.
I like that it's just clean and there isn't too much stuff. I don't like being overwhelmed by someone's portfolio.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like, enough already.
Yeah, so nicely done. I actually wish I had more constructive criticism for you. Here's another portfolio. That logo is cool. I have no idea what that says. His signature is as legible as mine.
Oh.
Justin knows that's nothing short of an insult.
Oh, the dog.
Oh, the dog. I love the off-center composition of these pictures, like pushed right to the edge of the screen. It's really compelling.
That's a cool shot.
Beautiful light, great expressions. I love the processing on that. Not afraid to go high key. That's something I really like. Good contrast on it still. I actually feel like the balance on this photo is a little off. I'd rather see your eyes up a little higher.
Oh, I love that shot.
Yeah, that is a great
dog
picture. The lighting there is what makes it.
Yeah.
Let's find out
what
really this person is doing. Maybe we can figure out their name.
About. You have to do
okay. So I know how to address you. I keep seeing Maddie Pro. That feels weird to call you Maddie Pro, but that's what we have to go with for the time being. Maddie Pro. Okay, cool picture of you, Maddie Pro. I kind of wish I knew your name.
I
love the sunglasses here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a pretty sweet portrait. It definitely gives you the feeling that he knows what he's doing and that he's kind of like a more creative and artistic photographer than like a technical straight up
photographer. I think that looks like an album cover and he would be like, he'd have like house beats.
Yeah.
Right? He looks cool.
Yeah. Still don't know your name. Okay.
Some things were never
meant to
be.
See if there's more to his photography. Okay, so just this one section of photography doesn't have multiple categories.
I like that it's simple.
Is good. Yeah, not too many pictures. You
and
get to look at these pictures.
And they were all good. It's not like I saw good ones and then thought, what's this doing here? Like, they were consistently good.
Yeah.
Keep it simple. I like that.
Nine pictures.
Ooh.
That's great. Not no categories, no
this
bus.
This is like a tough competition already.
Yeah.
You guys really stepped your game up. Okay.
Well, let's look at one more, and then we'll look at some individual pictures that you can send us at sdp.io/submit. Okay, this almost disappears up here. I almost couldn't see it, so you might consider changing the color so it's a little more bold. Minskoff photography. This is a Squarespace site, yes.
This looks unfamiliar to me.
Yeah, okay, so first I'm going to say there's a lot of duplicate subjects here. Like, we could probably pick one of these Buddha pictures.
I know it's a matter of taste, but also this layout, because the pictures aren't lined up, it looks really cluttered to me, and it's difficult for my eye to just focus on one picture. So I think I'd choose another layout.
Yeah, and Squarespace does have lots of options.
Yeah.
These 5, 6, 7 pictures of the same subject, pick one.
It's hard for me to bring my attention to just one picture. What about the fountain picture? Let's see what's up with that.
This one?
There are multiple fountain pictures. Okay, so you can go through it.
That one's cool. I like the composition there. Yeah, you can zoom in. That's true. But people will get bored seeing the same thing. They'll just be like, this is getting repetitive.
Yeah.
And it's just the modern world.
So,
people have short attention span.
If I were you, I would pick the best from each set. So one of the Buddha picture, one of the fountain, and just make it like your greatest hits.
Oh, I see. This is Instagram. I'm confused by the Instagram thing. It doesn't fit in with the rest of the user interface, so I might just make it link to Instagram. Oh, you have it there already. So I guess I would probably just get rid of this thing down here. That's a little confusing. Check out his contact page. I'd love to see...
It's uninviting.
Yeah.
It's a bit cool because there's... I don't know. Be nice to have a picture of you. And, hi, I'm so-and-so. Leave a message. Talk to me, something like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Leave an email in case people don't like these forms. A lot of people don't.
Yeah, great suggestion.
But you had some great pictures in there, and it's good. It's a good start.
Well, let's take a look at some reader submissions. These are pictures that they submitted while the show wasn't live, so we're not going to look at them. But it's fun to look at thumbnails, right? Thumbnails are one of the most important aspects of modern photography because they're what draws people in to look at your work. So you have to make a good-looking thumbnail. So we like to flip through and just see what catches our eye. This picture catches my eye because it's a close-up picture, eye contact, plus I like cameras. This is a good portrait. Again, it's tight, no distractions. This, too, I think is a great thumbnail.
Yeah, I like that.
You know right away what you're getting, and you might want to dig in more to see more detail. That's pro image. That might not be quite specific enough.
It is
kind of
big, yeah.
Oh, I really want to see this picture. Wow, that is a gorgeous fish.
That makes me hungry.
I love those dunes. That's a really pretty composition, too. What's catching your eye, Chels?
Old No Arms up there, top left. What's that called again?
Is it Venus de Milo?
I think so. I don't know.
Oh, Old No Arms. I'm sorry. This just in. It's Old No Arms.
if only.
Another good type portrait.
Yeah.
Good type portrait here. This is a good example of using lines in a picture, right? All the lines like lead to the subject's head. This picture's a little underexposed, so you might adjust the contrast of it a little bit, the brightness. But a good example of lines. A lot of pictures submitted.
Wow. Let's get out of here and go to the people that followed the rules.
Okay. Will do. Just have to import them real quick.
I have a picture of Old No Arms, too. I'll have to submit it to our show.
Okay. Oh, my goodness. We already have so many pictures.
How many? I see apples. I love apples.
Lines?
No.
I wouldn't say lines was a compositional element in that picture. Lines is a compositional element in this picture. First, the picture's a little dark. It's a little underexposed. Mm-hmm. You're going to want these God rays are kind of the subject of the picture, but you want them to be nice and bright white.
Yeah.
But the lines here all lead your eye right there. But there's nothing really happening here because the focal point is over here.
Right, because the lines on the right side of the water and the left side are converging to that point. So where lines converge, it draws your eyes there. So
I do like the composition here. One thing you can do with lines is change your position to manipulate where they are in your frame. So maybe it would have worked. You could have gone to the right so that these lines were more directly underneath the God rays.
Yeah, in theory. You never really know unless they're there. But
yeah, and it would have kind of skewed the perspective on this, yeah. But it's something to consider. This is definitely a case where there's lines, but again, they don't go anywhere. Don't you think?
It's very stagnant. I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
Vertical lines.
No lines.
They're kind of like...
I actually like the lines in this picture because they're all kind of parallel.
Yeah. There's the highway lines leading to the horizon. This is a very line and literal power lines.
Yeah, one of the effective ways to use lines is to kind of make a geometric shape that leads your eye back in through a picture. And for me, my eye kind of started here at the sun and then moved over to these power lines and then went back down here and then went back down here over here. So it kind of brings the eye in a circle. And so I do think this is an effective use of lines. Yeah, great work.
That person was at the Louvre too, so that must have been the Venus de Milo.
Oh, maybe so. It is a cool picture. I don't really see an effective use of lines. Cityscapes always have lines, but...
But these aren't leading lines.
No, and they don't necessarily have to be... Maybe we should have been more specific in the requirements, but we're trying to use lines as a compositional element here, which means it should be part of the composition where it should do something. And here, your eye comes from here and goes right into the corner where nothing is. And so it just ends up being frustrating, but it is a good picture.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. It's a beautiful... I shouldn't downplay it just because it didn't use lines effectively, but it is a good picture.
Yeah.
Here I feel like the lines work because your eyes
can go lead you down
right
the road
here, up to the Eiffel Tower. You definitely, with something like this, I know I'm always leveling stuff, but want to make sure that this Eiffel Tower is completely straight because it is just so straight. It's not the Leaning Tower, it's the Eiffel Tower.
Okay. All right.
We got it.
Whoa. I love this picture.
Yeah, I do too.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, this is really a picture that I needed to contemplate for a minute. Because of the powerful use of negative space.
Here. Oh, yeah.
And that line is so carefully placed.
There's like a really unusual balance to the picture, and I'm loving it.
Yeah, because it's almost perfect symmetry. The picture is divided almost perfectly in half, but one side is completely black and the other side is almost completely light. I just find that really powerful. I know it's not a picture that's going to get thousands of likes on Facebook because it's not a cute puppy or something, but I love this kind of artistic shot and that thoughtful composition.
It's really beautiful, and I love the leading lines here too, just drawing you back into like, it almost feels infinite.
Yes, they don't go anywhere, but in this shot, it really, really works. And the geometry really works here, too. We have triangles, squares, and circles.
Yeah.
And they all really add a lot to it. Yeah. Great eye. Fantastic
shot.
That's
such a cool picture.
Yeah. This really is going to stick with me. GH4, one of our favorite cameras.
Yeah, I was just noticing.
No use of lines.
Oh, that's an interesting one.
Yeah, this picture is almost entirely lines.
So like
the same person,
the leading line kind of brings you right into the horizon line, which is interesting.
Yeah, it really does lead down here, and there's no particular subject here, but I don't mind in this picture.
No, it's
you also have the line of the shadow bringing you through.
It works.
Beautiful.
The Brooklyn
here,
Bridge.
They lead right to something, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, the flag here. So
you
are kind of rewarded.
This person understood where we were going with it.
Yeah, that's a fantastic use of composition, though. They sent in more than one picture. We should have been more specific. S or FPV photography loves lines. These are great pictures. We do try to get people to only do one picture. We probably didn't say.
I'm not seeing.
There are a lot of lines in the picture. I don't know if they're a compositional element. I still feel like the picture's cool, though.
Yeah, it's
I like
cool
it.
Picture. That was the cutest skeleton I ever saw. Look at this guy.
Yeah, I like that. It. No lines.
Okay. Oh, I actually remember reviewing this person's portfolio a few months ago. He had the guy in the red hoodie, remember?
Mm.
Okay, I like this. I like it.
Yeah, the mood kind of matches the nothingness of the composition. Yeah. The fact that your eyes lead here and there's nothing there fits because of the way the processing is, the fact that it's nice and cool, it feels isolated. So I think the nothingness becomes part of the story. Here we see powerful lines. You don't have that same sort of mood. There's a good mood here, but yeah, they don't really lead back to the same place. Aaron Marr, it's the same person.
Kinda.
Yeah, lines. It's a cityscape. I wouldn't say the lines are really a compositional element here. They don't add much.
Yeah, we weren't very specific. I like the picture. Though. I'll give it to you guys.
Yeah. There are lines in these pictures. That's good. No lines, but cool picture. Also kind of a haunting picture. Full of lines. You want to see if there are any questions for us? We forgot to bring you down a computer so you could read comments.
Oh.
But I could look at some comments here. Questions. Chico asked, do you think the mirrorless camera will replace the DSLR?
I think so. I think that they just have to catch up with the lenses. That's one reason why I haven't really switched over is because I've liked some of the mirrorless cameras that I've used, but then I go to use them when I'm working and I just don't have a lens that I can use, especially for portraits or wildlife.
Yeah, we need to see an advancement in focusing systems before we can have them overtake wildlife and sports and such.
That actually reminds me, because when we were doing the 7D Mark II test, people were bringing up like a lot of Sony cameras that they felt outperformed it. But I was like saying to Justin, like, who cares if you don't have a lens to go with it? You can't have some excellent body and then a lens that's not going to be compatible with it to get the job done.
So, I know. Who's looking only at the sensor scores?
Well, a lot of people are. And it's
they
like,
really are.
It's really impressive. I'm not trying to downplay the accomplishment that they're making with these sensors and these bodies and everything, but it doesn't matter to me unless I can actually apply it in a real world scenario. And I'll need a lens before I can do that. So.
And one of the points I made in the earlier live show today was that the differences between the worst and the best are about one third of a stop. So you could more than triple that difference just by getting a lens that was one stop faster. So
that's a good point.
In the Canon world, if you can get an F4 lens, where in the Sony world there's only an F5.6 lens, then you've just blown away the image quality by the fact that you can shoot a stop faster and gather that much more light. Just something to factor in. It's all very relative. You can't always just compare ISO to ISO to ISO. It's not that simple.
Yeah.
There's a whole infrastructure. Anyway, we covered that in the photography buying guide. Check it out. another question, would stunning digital photography be good if I shoot in film and then take it to the PC?
Yeah, there's a lot of like things that apply. I mean, you're learning about exposure compensation and you're learning about composition and...
Yeah, I would say almost...
I'm trying to think of what wouldn't apply. Most of it applies.
I will say that when I wrote Stunning Digital Photography, I made a point. Every existing book had pretty much been written based on the film world, mm-hmm. because people were moving from film to digital. And I just wanted to say, hey, it's a clean slate. We're all shooting digital at this point. I did scan film for many years to get it in the digital world. So I am aware of the differences. But there are things like I recommend, instead of metering with a spot meter, maybe just taking a sample shot and then looking and reviewing your picture and then adjusting based on that. You can't really do that in film.
Yeah.
So you'll come across a few things that work in digital and don't work in film. But for the most part, most of the book will apply just perfectly. Aspects of composition, lighting, planning, all that
posing.
Will work fine. So, yeah, and if you don't like it, just tell me and I'll give you a refund.
I'll give you your money back if you don't like it. Okay. What else?
What do you guys think about median blending as a technique for reducing noise and images of static subjects? I tried it out and it seems to work amazingly well. I have not heard the term median blending.
No, I haven't either.
But I am familiar with a couple of terms for taking multiple pictures and then blending them together. You can either take 10 pictures at, say, 1/60th of a second and blend them all together. You average them. I guess that's what median blending would be.
Yeah.
So yeah, It'll work. And in my head, I've already planned out a video that I was planning to film as soon as we get a chance to show you how to get great image quality out of cameras that have lesser sensors so it can be done. The key factor here, the key factor in image quality we've determined through testing and research is total noise, total light gathered. It's not sensor technology, it's not your lens, it's total light gathered always. So what median blending will do is you'll take multiple pictures and then blend them together, but you're adding in the total light taken in 5 or 10 different pictures. So you're gathering 5 or 10 times more light, and that's what's going to be the biggest factor in the amount of noise. It's more work, you have to do post-processing, but you're still getting there. Winston Hong, are you guys going to ship outside of the USA, living in Canada? For the cameras, no. Because
it's too expensive.
It's expensive, and there's no great way to really track it.
That's true. Once it leaves the US, they stop tracking it, which is scary.
Yeah, we ship books and DVDs outside the US.
Yeah.
But sometimes people say, hey, I didn't get my book or DVD, and we're just like, there's no tracking, and so we'll send you another or refund your money or something.
We'll
but
we give your money back. That
we're
rarely
not
happens.
Do that with an expensive camera.
Yeah, but that's happened. And I mean, we've had a few people want us to ship our books to them, and like the addresses are crazy. Like they don't even have, like their address is like around the corner near this building, and like
there are countries where streets and houses, streets don't have names and houses don't have numbers. So you see an address that's like the red house by the fountain. No joke. And we have viewers all over the world thanks to the internet. And yes, things can be unreliable, and a lot of countries don't have legit customs practices.
Yeah.
Customs will steal your stuff.
Yeah, they'll be like,
they will.
This
they'll
looks
open
good.
It up, and if they like it, they will just steal it. It happens in a lot of countries. Or there's some sort of tariff that we don't know about. A lot of times you have to pay a tax when you ship goods to another country, and it's impossible for us to know that for every single country.
Yeah.
So we don't mind for books and videos, but for an expensive camera, we're not going to throw it away.
We really thoroughly answered that question.
Yeah.
How was New York?
Oh, they must be talking about Photo Plus.
Yeah, it was really fun, and all three of us were really overwhelmed. Like, we showed up really excited, and then we were just in a sea of people. We were like, what do we do? We just kind of meandered from booth to booth, checking out all of the things we were excited about. We had a lot of fun.
Yeah, we're three introverts that generally prefer
We should
quiet.
Have met Sam. Sam is like the resident extrovert.
Yeah.
She's always making connections and talking to people, and we're...
Samantha Shannon from Samantha Annette Photography, if you know her. And yeah, she works with us a lot and does our marketing stuff, and hired her specifically because she's an extrovert and she's good at that
I
stuff.
Feel, and
we made such a mistake. She would have been in her wheelhouse there just talking to people.
Yeah, she's amazing.
And
she's so good at talking
deals.
To people. And you guys were so nice. A lot of people approached us and said hi, and like you made us feel so good. And I always feel so embarrassed because... Like right now, I'm just talking to an empty room with cameras. So I'm like, people are like, you're so outgoing. And then I meet people and I'm like, hi.
Hi, oh yeah, thank you.
Oh yeah, I forgot real people look at me. Yeah, we're dweebs. We had fun though.
You know who's good at that is Jared Polin.
Oh, we saw Jared Polin. He's just like, what up?
He's totally an extrovert. He's out talking to everybody. He's like wheeling and dealing and making contacts. And we're like,
Scott
we know
Kelby.
That person, but he looks busy. We'll like come back
Scott
later.
Scott Kelby was like, he was like a rock star.
Yeah.
I saw a guy from Flurn. I don't know his name, but he looked really cool. Everybody was networking. We're just dweebs.
We saw Donnie Diamond, who we've talked to, but he was like surrounded by people. Oh, and so God. We kept being like, well, we'll come back when he's not busy. But then it was never not busy.
I don't want to bother him. We're nerds. I'll get better at it. T-Gar.
Where's the big button that goes into the button hole on your lapel? I do not know what T-Gar is talking about.
You have this big empty...
Yeah, I see it.
Oh.
What the heck? That's a ripoff. It came with a button hole, but not a button?
Yeah, and what am I supposed to do? Like, fold it over and... Button it? Man, I hate non-functional things. What else? Oh, my pockets are functional. Sometimes you get the non-functional pockets, and that's enraging.
That coat is nonsense.
Yeah.
Thank you, T-Gar, for bringing that to our attention.
I don't know what this question means, but Tony, by your jacket, do you moonlight as an Austrian Burgermeister?
I don't know what that is, but that sounds hot as hell.
I've had burgers in Austria. No, yeah, Burgermeister.
What?
I guess they dress like me right now, and my jacket is... sparking conversation.
I think it's a hot ass stripper or something because you look good to me. You, my favorite Burgermeister, honey.
I do not remember my MBTI types, but I will say I or the E switch for me. I've been an introvert and an extrovert at different times in my life. It just depends. If I'm too secluded, I used to live in the wilderness in Massachusetts for months at a time, and I was a single guy, and I was a total tested as an extrovert at the time. And everybody I talked to, I would strike up conversation with the
bag
cashiers
lady
and
at
stuff.
The grocery store. You're like, "Hi, I'm Tony. I haven't seen a person for 3 weeks."
Yeah, but then I move into civilization again, and I pretty quickly become an introvert.
You reach your limit. What else?
I don't remember all the codes.
Oh, this person, I want Tony's jacket. Please, guys, raffle that thing off or something. The jacket was woven from fallen silver, Tony's hairs. God.
I had no idea the jacket
Much
would be
Chelsea,
a conversation topic.
Much Chelsea, such hoodie, so trendy, very youth, wow.
Please do the rest of the show with the hood on, it says. I don't
you
know
what
why
I like
to
do
that.
That's like, oh, I think I can't because my mic is mic'd up, but one thing that really turns the men on, ladies, you have to tuck your ears in front of the hoodie.
Oh, you can't do that while I'm on camera, Chels.
It's real hot.
I'm going to knock this table right over.
Okay. Oh, my God.
It took a second. Mikhail says, bring Stop It back. Stop It's our segment where we make fun of people's pictures.
I love Stop It.
What's the problem with Stop It, Chels?
Nobody will submit their pictures. And I was like trying to prime the pump by putting all of my old pictures in. And Tony was ripping me a new one every episode, and it was hilarious.
I love making fun of pictures.
And nobody else, like, a few people were like, all right, I'll sacrifice myself for the entertainment, but as it turns out, nobody wants to be made fun of.
Yeah, we see people's embarrassing pictures, like
all
their cheesy HDR and
like an HDR of a person.
Spot color.
A spot color, like if I just spot colored your buttonhole.
Oh, the worst are like the glamour shots where they get some chick that they know to like try to pose sexy and it gets all
they're
uncomfortable.
Like in like underwear that are kind of old and they're like, but nobody wants to be a part of it.
Yeah, so that's what happened to Stop
what
It.
What if we did involuntary Stop It?
Oh, that would be terrible. It would be an assault on people. That would crush. but it would be hilarious.
A Burgermeister is a mayor. So
oh, it looked like an Austrian mayor. Okay. I was kind of hoping they made burgers. you can go to sdp.io/stopit. Is that right?
Yeah.
To
can
send us your
them.
Pictures. And
you guys
we'll
should do it.
Take a look at it. Go to sdp.io/stopit and we'll look at your pictures.
It.
And if you guys have enough pictures, we'll make fun of them.
We'll totally make fun of them.
Get the permission of whatever chick you made pose sexy, though, before you do it, because we might make fun of her, too.
We should just do my early ones when we thought it was a good idea.
Let's back up a little bit and tell these people what the portfolios reviewed had to say about Squarespace. Rad said Squarespace is very friendly, easy to use and set up, good selection of templates, pro-looking website in just a few minutes.
They look so pro. What's worse than when you go on someone's website and they could have really good pictures, but there's like clip art in the background or something.
Yeah, it looks like they use the web module in Lightroom to make their portfolio. Don't do that. Just go to squarespace.com. It's worth $8 a month or whatever it costs.
It's like, yeah.
Squarespace lets you cut to the chase. This is from Maddie Pro, that second portfolio Maddie that Pro. We reviewed. You can invest hours of time in designing, building, planning, navigation, getting your site to work across multiple browsers, technical stuff that's really a pain. But with Squarespace, you spend your time on your content and updating is instantaneous. The most effective way of building a quality performing site for regularly updated content and a professional finish, appearance, and navigation.
He's good. We need a third chair for this guy right
here. Yeah, he's writing marketing copy here. That's
Same.
Amazing.
Thanks.
Maddie, bro, you are Maddie. A writer. Meanscoff, I started using Squarespace about a month ago. It's really easy to upload your photos in seconds. Yeah, that's what we like about it too. It's easy to use. It works with your iPhone and your Samsung S5 and your iPad and your tablet and your Mac and your PC.
What?
Something happened.
Oh, well, they have a really good portfolio app and I wanted to show it to people and make a video, but I'll have to do it another time.
Oh, okay. Well, if you're interested in your own Squarespace portfolio, they're awesome. They make your pictures look great. Go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio for 10% off after your free trial. No credit card required. So just try it out.
Just try it. You don't have
they
to
don't
buy it.
Take any credit card from you, so it'll automatically expire and they won't charge you. It's not one of those will automatically charge you unless you find a way
That's
to cancel
BS.
Things.
Yeah.
That's BS. Chelsea says it.
That's BS. Straight from the Chelsea's mouth.
Let's look at a couple
other. That just
other...
feels like of course to me.
It feels like, of course. It feels like you're making fun of me, though.
Some guy was like, some of the things Chelsea says under her breath would make a man go crazy. What do I say, Justin? Tony's such a bitch. It's not like I'm saying anything like that. This is a beautiful picture.
I love that. Yeah, I really do.
Oh my gosh, that's gorgeous. Oh my gosh, you
yeah,
have such an
another
eye
great
for
use of
color.
Colors. You're beautiful.
Oh, damn, where have you been? I want to hang out with this person.
Gorgeous. Really great fine art. Wow.
What the hell?
This person's getting around.
This person's insane.
Oh, just beautiful. That's a great use of lines, by the way.
You stop it. You stop impressing me like this.
It's not the proper use of stop it, Chels.
Oh. I invented stop it. You can't tell me, sir.
Oh, that's... Is that the...
No.
Spot color. Not our favorite.
Yeah, but you know what? I trust this guy. Oh, wow. Wait. Go back.
That's sweet.
Oh. Okay. No.
No, it's not.
No.
I keep thinking we've been to these places and...
They're like, nope. I want to travel with this person. Who
yeah,
are you?
Beautiful
Where
photos
are you?
Of Mexico. I love the use of colors. Great fine art portfolio.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I love the steam there. Great balance in the picture.
Is that a tortilla?
It's a pizzeria. Some Spanish that I know. Some gorgeous. I love filling the frame. This is a great use of patterns, which we discussed in chapter 2 of SDP.
You do that well.
Just really nice. Though I might even go for more depth of field and get all of that in focus.
Okay.
Doesn't hurt.
You tell them. That's a cool.
Little spot color, but it didn't bother me.
I didn't even notice.
Yeah, great pictures. Let's check out their black and white. It must be good, right?
Yeah. But I just need to see who this person is. The old under the armpit shot.
Okay, let's jump to the about page. Gabriel Wortman.
Born
and based in Mexico City.
Oh, Mexico
City. That explains it. Oh, that's definitely Austria, right?
Why
do I even guess?
Stop.
Oh,
because
Prague. It must be Prague.
No, let's just give up.
These pictures are from Prague, though.
Oh, whoa, go back. Slow down.
Yeah, that's an intense picture. I love the way you brought out the sky. That's
I want a garden
definitely
like
HDR
that.
Or heavily recovered highlights, but it turned out really good.
Yeah.
I like that kind of abstract.
Whoa.
I hope that's light painting and not like a car that bounced off the road.
Wow, that's a cool.
Beautiful abstract shot.
Whoa. Is that? No.
It's in Prague. What's with cities that have different names in different places? Like, why do we call it Prague when they seem to call it, like,
Praha?
Praha?
Well, everyone, there's a different name in every language, I think.
But it's a name. Like,
I know.
It's not like people in Istanbul call me Tanya or something. No, they would still do their best to say Tony, right? But we call it Florence, and the Italians call it Firenze. That makes no sense. Why did we decide that we could rename your stuff? That seems like a very American thing to do. Like,
yeah, but we're not the only
Prague.
Ones that do it. I don't know why. I can't explain. It seems wrong to me too, but it happens.
Yeah, let's all get real. Together and just agree on a single name.
Right. I actually think that he could pare this down a little bit.
Yeah,
he has some,
that was going to be my feedback.
He has some pictures, or he or she has pictures that are just like, they're insane. They're really good. And then you have some that are a bit snapshotty. And I would just weed them out.
Yeah, just basically a few too many pictures. So I tried to give some feedback as I went. I think that picture's gorgeous.
That
I don't know if that's in your
gum.
Main portfolio or not, but it makes you want gum.
Yeah. Like a winter fresh gum.
Okay. Thanks, Gabriel. We'll definitely keep you in mind for the big winner of the show. Rob Spradlin.
Wait,
photography.
When we're judging the portfolio, is it based on the attractiveness of the portfolio layout itself or all of the pictures within the portfolio or a combination?
I would say it's the best overall presentation, but I think it's mostly the pictures.
I think it's, all right, it's both.
I will say I love this sort of full screen layout. It can be a little tricky when you're doing the layout because sometimes people visit it with a smartphone. And the smartphone will be vertical instead because they're holding it in their hand. Squarespace is pretty good about that. It gives you a chance to set the focal point. It'll make sure the focal point is in the picture.
Yeah.
But it's something to be careful of. But nonetheless, it seems made for a horizontal layout, and it looks pretty great.
It looks pretty. Guy's too cool for school.
Yeah, great texture and grain, great contrast. I like that a lot. A lot of personality in that shot. Beautiful mood and lighting.
I think I've seen that.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. I think we've reviewed this man's pictures.
Oh.
The monkey.
Oh, really? That's gorgeous.
He looks happy. He's
this
like, oh,
doesn't seem to fit in
this crap
with the
again.
Rest. Wow. Okay, this is a lot of categories that people aren't
furry
really
children.
Get through.
Please don't let it be pets.
Oh,
oh
it's
okay,
those.
Pets.
What are those people, the grown adults who dress
Furries.
Up? Furries?
Yeah.
Is that what they're called?
Yeah. Look at the cat.
I do recognize
at the
that
banister.
Picture. Yeah. Yeah. That's a good use of lines, actually.
These are fun. Oh, I love your picture.
Commerce. First,
look at that monkey.
We haven't done the under construction page since like 1998.
No, people still do it. You need the little guy digging.
Yeah, so just take the link down until it's ready.
Maybe he wants to compel you to come back. You got something to say to me?
I don't know why he's got to get all mad at me. What have I ever done to him?
Why'd you have to hurt my feelings?
Not to be all threatening. Now, okay. Now you're
just
clearly changing your mind about me.
Sir.
Really insulting. Okay. Thanks,
this
Rob.
This guy's crazy. I think I'd be friends with him.
Let's look at another portfolio and then we can go back to looking at some individual pictures.
Whoa.
Simply photography, capturing your moments.
Is that a threat?
I think these are, like, we can browse individual categories. Oh, I see. I jumped to the thumbnail.
Look at that.
Oh, I jumped into the wildlife category. That picture I really like. I love the kind of balance of it. Good focus on the eyes there. I'd probably drop that one from the portfolio.
Yeah,
people really don't like to see that, or spend the time and actually remove all the rest of it and then up the contrast a little bit. But, okay, see if we can get back out here. Landscape. See if I can just jump back to your main portfolio. Great contrast in that picture. Love the sky, and you can kind of see it raining in the distance there. Nice kind of abstract landscape shot. You know, this shot doesn't fit in for me because I think the subject is certainly cool, but his eyes are a little out of focus. The focus is clearly here on the tree. Your camera just missed focus.
Okay.
I would pull it.
I would pull it. I second that motion.
This picture is fantastic.
Love that picture.
Yeah.
I want to swim there.
Take a look at a couple more of their travel pictures. These all look just great to me. I love that shot. I love the shots of the people especially. I think those are really strong. Great composition there. Still don't know your name, which I like to see. Maybe it's under the contact page. Nope. Tell us your name. Love that you have a picture of you. I think everything goes really well. I've been suggesting people merge their about and contact pages.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people have separate pages, but it's just because it's that way in the Squarespace
yeah.
template. So go ahead and merge them. It's pretty easy to add a form to your about page, and Squarespace makes that pretty simple. You want to take a look at some more individual pictures that
Let's
people
see if we
submitted
can find
in
some
real
lines.
Time?
This show's going by fast for me. It's almost 6. I just feel like it's like
yeah,
keeping that action
keeping
going.
Keeping it going.
Got my hoodie on.
Maybe it's
on.
That coffee that you had.
Yeah.
Good use of lines. You know what I would do is I'd camp out there. Maybe that's your car, but I'd camp out there and wait for an interesting car to go past, or dress up a friend with an umbrella and a suitcase and kind of put them down there. It's a great spot for a portrait or something. You kind of want a focal point there.
I would rent a llama.
Llamas. No lines, cute kid.
Ooh.
This is a cool shot.
Ooh,
what's going
what
on
is
down
that?
There? Is that what you wanted to look
yeah.
at?
Yeah. Oh, that's so
I
weird.
I thought maybe we'd have to call CSI or something.
What happened? What's the story? There's still a license plate.
I can only think that it was a meth lab.
Is that because you like Breaking Bad? I like that picture.
Yeah, I do like that picture, even though you broke the rule. Submitting a picture with lions, it really caught our eye. Like the contrast that you put in the sky too. lines, not necessarily a focal
point.
What's
this, dragon?
That's an interesting concept. It looks like light painting with a silhouette. Kind of a cool idea. That's something I've thought about before. This just makes me think spaghetti western set. I don't know what to think of this.
Me either.
Interesting. That's the same person.
No lines.
No lines. Pretty picture though.
Yeah, there's some leading lines there. Okay.
Yeah. Powerful use of lines. I do think the lines are the main compositional element here. I like that picture.
Ooh.
There are horizontal lines here, but they don't really do anything.
I like it.
Yeah, there is something about it I like too. These are often the same person. Okay, this is a different person. He's cute.
He looks like smushed.
This is definitely lines, but again, I wish there was something just right there.
There needs to be a payoff sometimes.
Yeah. Skipping these because they seem to be the same person.
That duck looks smug, right? He's like, bastard.
You shut the hell up, duck. Yeah. Don't look at me like that. I like this picture because you found the subject and you like really
like
filled the frame with it, and it's cluttered, but that's what it's conveying. So I like that.
It makes
shot.
Me nervous. I don't like clutter.
Oh, sorry. It's cute.
Yeah, that's lines, like the two converge and frame him.
Yeah, and I would actually suggest that you simplify the lines a little bit. I would go ahead and take out this branch here in Photoshop and remove that in Photoshop. Chapter 8 of Sending Digital Photography has some information about that. And you can check out our Lightroom book, scp.io/LR. We show some tips for post-processing.
Amazon,
it's also a good opportunity to remove the noise here.
Amazon has our Lightroom book on pre-sale for like $18 or something.
It's
got like 12 hours of video.
It's cheaper than we're selling it for.
Yeah.
But if you buy it from us, if you pre-order from us, you'll get it about a week sooner
and
you'll
signed.
Get it signed by both of us.
I just thought that was a crazy
thing. And you'll get instant access to the beta of the ebook.
That's true.
But you can get it from Amazon too.
Yeah. Just saying.
Oh, suburbia, right? That's what this conveys to me. It's like Americana. And if that's the theme, then I'd love to see like a kid with
a razor
little red
scooter.
Wagon or a scooter, yeah. A lemonade stand or just some other focal point would have helped. I like the texture here.
Looks like
it seems
infrared.
A little underexposed. You know, I wouldn't mind just bringing it up a little bit.
Ooh.
If the sun were poking through there a little bit,
huh.
Might be a good focal point for it.
Oh, sorry. Cool.
Yeah, that's definitely a cool shot. A mix between straight lines and curved lines. I think the geometry really helps that picture.
I don't see lines, but I like that shot.
Yeah, interesting shot.
Whoa.
Okay. Some spidey nuts.
Someone went to come. Oh, go to that one.
This
I love
one?
That shot. No. That one.
Yeah.
That's a cool shot.
Yeah, I like the. I would have missed the dog at first glance, but the lines kind of lead you right in there. Another set of lines converging, looking for a focal point, I think. But I love the kind of moody scene.
It's very scary.
Yeah. I wouldn't hesitate to make it a little brighter, though.
Really?
Yeah.
What's that?
I don't know. Oh, beautiful trees.
I don't know.
I've never heard of a Dimage A1.
That must be the same person.
Oh, did you see it before? I love the shot. Looks like a Windows screensaver almost, like nicing, simple, clean composition. I would suggest going in and just really removing the noise. You can do a lot of it in Lightroom down here in the detail pane.
How are we gonna get people to just submit one picture though?
Yeah.
Should I call their mom?
That seems like the best choice. A lot
That's
of tree
beautiful.
Pictures today, that is really nice.
It's a little underexposed.
Yep.
Yeah, just look at that histogram and you can see you got to up the contrast a little bit. It's a little flat. This picture, look at that histogram spread out across the whole thing. And indeed,
dang.
It does feel like it has a whole lot of contrast.
Check out the histogram on that.
Really cool. And here your eyes kind of lead behind the scenes here, but I like it.
I like it. Oh, very intense.
No sense of
lines, though.
Oh,
wow.
That's, whoa. Elizabeth.
Oh,
know this
great shot, Elizabeth. Yeah. I love the symmetry here, especially the mix of
very
straight
cool.
and curved
yeah.
lines. Really nicely
really
done.
Really good.
Yeah, beautiful curved lines here. I'll say I'm not a fan of the thick framing.
Is that
unnecessary? But
can you just tell me if that's in Bath, England? Maybe I'm wrong. I'm always wrong.
I wouldn't say that has a powerful use of lines. Simply Photography. Well, we just reviewed your portfolio.
Yeah,
so
come on.
Saw that shot.
Calling your mom. Start writing down their names. We have to pick a winner for the portfolio, right?
Yeah, I briefly thought that was me in the picture. Okay.
You've never been there.
I don't know every place I've been.
Well, who's it going to be?
Okay, so we have Gabriel Wortmann. He had some gorgeous pictures.
I like this guy because he like offended us. And there's something appealing about that to me.
Yeah. We have Simply Photography.
Yeah, he had some great photos.
Minskoff.
Okay. We didn't. Did we look at this?
I don't think we did.
We didn't.
Oh, okay. I love the composition of that one. Really nice. Great use of lines.
Yeah.
Doing a very impromptu review of your portfolio. Sorry we didn't do it earlier. Great lighting on that. I wouldn't. The catch lights. Be nice if you moved it off camera, but as far as moving it on, having it on camera, that's really nice. Unusual wolf for a Little Red Riding Hood scene, but I like it.
Okay.
Great portrait. Sorry we got to it at the end of the show, but it seems like your website looks great. The Rad Pet Photography had some great shots of pets. Maddie Pro also had some great portraits. And, oh. Minskoff, seems like we reviewed that already. So, which of those do you feel most passionate about? Who really struck you?
I liked the guy with all the colors.
That's what I was thinking too. Gabriel?
Yeah, it's so clean and crisp. I like that I can read his logo, but it's still like, I don't know, it's got something to it that's memorable, just the script.
Yeah, thanks, Gabriel. Drop us a note with your from your official email there, and we'll get your address and send you some free stuff.
Yeah.
The
just email us at tony@northrup.org.
We'll send you the Lightroom 5 video book, which you can check out at sdp.io/LR. It's for pre-sale now. We'll ship the paperback book in a couple of weeks, but you can get instant access to almost all of the 12 hours of video. And
we need to update this because
that's an old cover.
It's got 12 hours of video. It's like, how many pages?
It's about, I think the paperback is 250 pages, but there's a bonus chapter that you can download. And it's all really tight material. I cover Lightroom really, really, really thoroughly.
He's
every
concise.
Aspect of it. And the paperback is $19.99. The ebook is $9.99. Check it out or get it on Amazon. Before we leave, let's see if anybody else had any good questions for us.
Oh, wow.
How far away do you think technology is from creating a sensor capable of capturing all the light in front of it in such a way that all aspects may be manipulated in post-processing? This is something I actually think about a lot.
I wasn't listening.
He's asking, right now we have sensors that really capture light in a very simple way. There's a little red, blue, green filter in front of it.
Yep.
And so each pixel picks up basically only one range of frequencies of light, which means about a quarter of the light is dropped.
Right.
And all that we know about the light is a photon hit the pixel. We don't know the precise frequency of it. We don't know the direction of it. So there are some interesting alternatives. The foveon lights, the foveon sensors capture any range in a single pixel.
Okay.
And then the LITRO sensors can kind of capture the direction of light, and that lets you change the focus later.
Oh, that's how that works.
Yeah. I think that's kind of, we also kind of rely on lenses to pull light in a very specific way rather than capturing everything. So I'm going to say we're going to have to wait until the, what is it called? Not the Unity.
When the Singularity.
The Singularity.
When because people and machines become one?
When machines become smarter than people and begin to design the next generation of machines. I'm going to say, wild estimate, I'm going to say about 30 years.
Tony's predicting the singularity.
Yeah, yeah. I'm giving it about 30 years when artificial intelligence will become to the point where
you're really like
we'll be able to
dropping a bomb on all of us tonight. Okay. You really take on the challenging questions.
What do you think would produce better sharpness results and overall image quality when printing large, the D7100 with the new 80 to 400 or the 70 Mark II with the 400 F56? Well, first, those were at very different price points because the new 80 to 400 is like $2,300 or something. And that 400 F56 is like $1,300. For me, without looking at formal tests or anything, I would pick the 70 Mark II, much higher frame rate, much longer buffer. And with wildlife, those are really, really key factors. The sharpness on that prime lens is great, and it's also way lighter than the 80 to 400 zoom. And that's that helps you get pictures, the fact that you can hold it up for longer. Because how often do you want to take a shot, like today or yesterday, you were waiting for those ducks to pop out of the water.
My arms wouldn't
hold out. With that 500 millimeter.
Like, yeah, it's so heavy.
Yeah, so they pop up randomly.
People do use a monopod, but I guess I'm stubborn. But yeah.
Yeah, but the lightweight lens really does help you get more shots. So I would definitely pick the 70 Mark II over the D7100. Camille asks what a normal work week looks like in the Northrop House.
It's actually probably more common like than you would think. I think we work like, I don't know, wake up and maybe start working at 8 to 6 or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's tough to say what a normal work week looks like because literally the only thing that's normal every week is that we do this show.
Yeah.
Like for the past 3 weeks, past month or so, we've been working really hard and heavy on the Lightroom book. But that's unusual for us. Often we're doing camera reviews. Often we're doing photo shoots and actually taking pictures. Wish we did more of that.
Like writing educational content. Like sometimes we spend a lot of time thinking of new concepts, like calling people's questions and figuring out what people need to learn and then trying to make a video around it. We do a lot of different things. 1 week we spent on our taxes.
Yeah, actually taxes and paperwork and just trying to run a business takes
a lot of paperwork.
Time for all photographers who are doing it full time. Yeah, you get sucked into stuff you're doing. Doing stuff that you just hate.
Pretty typical.
Could you set up a filter to auto remove successive pics from the same author? Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I was a developer for years and I think I just need to hire a developer to do this. Brazil and Japan want you to say hi, Brazil and Japan. I'd love a review from you guys about the Sony SLT Alpha 58, even though it isn't Canon or Nikon. We review a lot of cameras that aren't Canon or Nikon. We've never gotten into the Sony Alpha SLTs, and I don't really know why. I'll say I'm not completely confident, but I'm not sure Sony's going to continue to support them. I think Sony's putting all their energy into mirrorless, and so I'm more interested in the Sony mirrorless cameras than the SLTs.
I'm still laughing at the Burgermeister comments. Burgermeister is from a Christmas movie. He's a mayor that banned toys from the town.
I would ban toys, though. They're a waste of time.
And Giselle said, please call my mom. Fix her internet while you're at it. Giselle.
What are you talking about, Giselle?
No, her mom's always asking her for, like, tech support. I've met my own mom. Her computer is an iPad. And if you touch it, then everything that breaks after that is your fault. So I'm not taking on your mom, too.
Most of the time, the answer to the problem is type the correct password, though.
And then people are suggesting how we get someone to just upload one picture. I don't know. It's so complicated.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
It's time. We're going to go see the movie Interstellar tonight, I think. Is that what it's called, Justin?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Interstellar. It looks good. We like science fiction stuff.
Okay.
See you Thursday is at 5 o'clock. Thanks
Thursday's
to our sponsor, Squarespace, if you're interested in
Squarespace
portfolio. Go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio. See you next week. Bye, guys.